Thank you, Kate, and good morning, everyone. Good morning. So I wasn't sure whether you will all be awake. I came this morning, woke up at 5:30, came from Orange County, especially for this. But after that last two screams, I'm sure whoever was sleeping is wide awake now. So so it's really, you know, I wanted to be here today, especially for this event organized for you, the educators. So it really means it's very special to me to be here. And on behalf of Broadcom, I welcome you to this event, Design, Code, and Build. It turns, I'm from India originally. I've been living here for about more than 30 years now. Came here as a grad student. Turns out that educators have a very, very, very special place in our culture. There is a four-word phrase. It basically is mother, father, teacher, God. That's it. And there are many, many interpretations for what that really means, because whoever created it, no one knows why these four words hang together. But whatever it is, you have to remember that the word that includes mother, father, God, you can understand, teachers, why. Definitely didn't say doctors, lawyers, bankers, engineers, and so on. So always grew up with that. It's almost like every morning, as part of some of the prayers, we would say these four words and go, not thinking too much about it. But somehow, it became ingrained in many of us, that, hey, educators are very, very special. So really thank you for all being here, for you all being here today, and, I appreciate that. With regards to Kate has told me I should, do it in very, few minutes, maybe 4 to 5 minutes. So I will try to be short. I first want to talk about computing. Computing is, I think we all know, it's extremely important. Coding is great, building is great, but I think having, it's not necessary that they all have to go into that profession, but having that knowledge is extremely important. And look at what's happening in our world today, with everything we carry on, whether it's the phones, whether it's the appliances in the home, what we watch on TV, everything has computing. Our cars are getting smarter, but more important is, even with regards to our health, I don't know how many of you saw the news a few days ago, maybe within the last week, one of the football players in Massachusetts High School was not feeling well, and essentially after the practice, he was happened to wear the Apple Watch, and he looked at the watch, and it was showing 100, and maybe an hour after the game or something like that, it was still showing 145 beats per minute. And that got him extremely concerned, went and checked it, and sure, he had some heart-related issue, right? So, computing and all this world of what we wear and everything, is going to become important. So it's going to be seamless, it's going to pervade, and it's important for us to understand what all these things mean, whether we are in that profession or not. So in that sense, I'm glad that you're all here today trying to understand, what computing is all about. Many of you hopefully are, very hands-on in all these things, and some of you, I'm sure, are new to this. And the main thing is to enjoy and have fun. I was also asked to briefly explain why I am an engineer, and unlike many, many folks who essentially were curious about why things work, mine was none of those. It turned out to be, again, due to four teachers. The first one was my brother. It turned out that he was the first engineer in my family, not even my family, my extended family, of all the immediate relatives and so on. And everyone, and there was something special about that, because everyone was like, wow, that was something nice. So, even as a young kid, he's about 11 years older to me. He actually is a professor today, and he was a fantastic teacher. So he taught me actually all the subjects, other than the teachers that I learned from. If I have doubts, I would go to him, and he always was very crisp and clear. So I always thought that, well, there is something to engineering. He somehow seems to know everything, right? So so that was an inspiration. And then it turned out that my math teacher, I was not that good at math, but somewhere around my 8th grade or 9th grade, my math teacher actually made me extremely curious about math, not through the subject, but through extracurricular math, puzzles, tricks, and all kinds of things. And he said, when I was able to solve those, he said, hey, there is a lot of connections between this and math that you don't even know about. And so I became extremely curious about math. And then my brother tied the two things together saying, hey, engineering and math go together. So he brought me a lot of books in physics and electronics and things like that. We, you know, back in the 70s, we didn't have computing, we didn't have any of these kits that you have access, that everyone has access to today. So it was all, I had to learn from books. And then, you know, that led me naturally into engineering. And then, you know, during the time of engineering, I had to figure out what engineering I do. And it turned out that one of the professors inspired me really to go into communications engineering, which essentially, you know, as we know it today, it is, think of it as, hey, I'm communicating with my cell phone, whether I'm talking, texting, messaging, browsing the internet, whatever it may be. Back in the 80s, when I was doing grad school, you know, other than, you know, even the concept of a cell phone didn't exist. You know, when I graduated, I worked at a place called Bell Labs, which essentially did a lot of the fundamental technology for cellular, and I was involved with many of those people as well. So it was a great, great experience for about 15 years working in the area of communications, and saw the entire area of wireless cellular all blossom. I still remember, you know, doing some of the very, very first digital cellular systems. And I used to have a board in my car, which was essentially mounted on a piece of wooden plank, which was probably about this thick, and probably 2 feet by 2 feet wide, sitting in the back seat of my Honda Accord. And every so often, I would put the antenna up on top and drive around and see whether, you know, we could make calls, how often the calls dropped, all those kinds of things. From there to essentially having this device today, a little device, essentially was probably very, very hard to imagine about 30 years ago. So it's been an incredible journey. And, you know, I came to Broadcom, you know, I was mainly a researcher for about 15 years at Bell Labs, which was the, you know, foremost industrial research place for technologies like communications and so on. Back in the East Coast, that's where I was. And then I came about 15 years ago to West Coast and essentially joined Broadcom, where I could learn how to translate all of this into practice and essentially get them into devices of this form. Worked with incredible engineers such as, for example, Dr. Frank Van Deglen, who is here. So essentially, he is one of the major, major contributors in the world to navigation technology. So if navigation all works wonderfully in the phone, we have to thank him for that. You know, it's just incredible to work with engineers of that talent and really make a meaningful difference to billions of people in the world. So that's what technology and engineering is all about. You really are able to impact. Just like education, in some sense, you literally are impacting people's lives in a very, very significant way, and hopefully most of it is for the good. So I really hope that, with that I will stop, I really hope that you have a, you know, enjoyable day today, and have fun, and, you know, the kids are all there. It's a nice role reversal of kids becoming the educators and you becoming the students, so kids can have some fun on your behalf. So it should be great. So looking forward to meeting some of you during the remainder of the time I'm here. Thank you.